This is a teasmade, and it is the most British invention. It's a combination alarm clock and electric kettle, which means that it has two settings, alarm and alarm with tea. Unlike a lot of clocks that are built into appliances, so clocks on ovens and microwaves and old-style clock radios and central heating systems, this clock keeps time by using the frequency of the power grid that it's connected to, or would be connected to. Anyway, obviously, I don't have power out here. Power grids on this side of the Atlantic run at a frequency of 50 hertz, 50 cycles a second. Now that 50 hertz frequency might rise or fall by a tiny fraction as supply and demand affect the grid, but over the course of days and weeks, the electricity companies guarantee that it'll be averaged out to 50 hertz. So clocks like this, which have to be plugged into the grid anyway, can use that regular 50 cycles a second beat to keep themselves accurate. Set this to the correct time, and it'll keep the correct time, as long as the power's on. Except, over the last month, clocks over in Europe have lost 6 minutes. If they're connected to the continental European power system, which is one connected, synchronized grid stretching all the way from Spain to Denmark to Turkey, if that clock is connected to that grid, it's 6 minutes slow. This was revealed in a press release a couple of days ago from the European Transmission Operators Association, who managed to write a press release that sounded vaguely like an angry parent who was getting close to the end of their rope. The problem is politics. Serbia and Kosovo have fallen out with each other. That is an enormous simplification, but if you think I'm going to try and explain the history of the Balkan politics system while holding a teasmade, you are sorely mistaken. Kosovo is low on power, Serbia isn't helping manage it, and as a result, the entire European grid has been slightly underpowered since the middle of January. Not by much, but enough that the average grid frequency has dropped from 50 hertz to 49.996. So clocks like this, who are expecting 50, okay, it doesn't sound like much, but it works out to them losing 6 minutes over the last couple of months. Problem number one is getting the grid back up to frequency, and hopefully politics will solve that. But problem number two is, when it is fixed, should the European authorities bring the grid back to 50, or should they run it slightly fast for a few weeks? If they do, it'll bring everything back that wasn't manually corrected, but anyone who has already changed their clocks will then find them starting to run 6 minutes fast, and they'll have to change them again. They're probably going to pick the second option, but who knows? Fortunately for me, I don't have to worry about it, as I'm sure 52% of Britons will be ecstatic to hear the mainland European grid is not synchronised to the British national grid here. It is connected through two undersea cables, one under the English Channel from France and the other one from the Netherlands, landing right here on the Isle of Grain, which is near nowhere. It's absolutely in the middle of nowhere. But these cables are direct current cables, not alternating current. They don't require grid synchronisation. So while mainland Europe's grid is slow, our British grid is going at 50 British cycles a second, as Her Majesty intended. Our ovens are turning on at the right time. Our clock radios are remaining on time. Our microwaves are showing the correct time, or they're showing 12 o'clock because no one's bothered to program them, but that's not the point. The point is that the clocks may be going slow all over Europe, but here in Britain, our teasmades are boiling precisely on schedule. God save the Queen, and God help us all. Good. I think that's a take.